This is Dear Shu Mishnah Berurah, and today we're going to be learning Simin Nun and Simin Nun Aleph, Sif Aleph and Beis. We begin Simin Nun, in which the Mechaber coins as Tam Lama Imrim Mishnas Izeu Mekayman. Again, a halacha that the title itself tells most of the story. Many people wonder, do we even have to say Izeu Mekayman? The Mechaber begins with, not that you have to say it, this is the reason that we say it. Says the Mechaber, Kavulish Nois Achar Parshas Atamid. After Parshas HaTamid, what do we say? Parakei Zeh Mekoyimim Ubraisa Derev Yishma. Why? Kidei Sheyizkei Kol Adam Lilma V'Chayom Mikra Mishnah Gemara. So we should merit to learn every day Mikra Mishnah and Gemara. The Braisa Derev Yishma L'Avimakam Gemara. That Braisa is Gemara. Sheh Medrash Ki Gemara. Because Medrash is like a Gemara. So says the Mishnah Berurah Sif Katan Alel Kavu Lishnois V'Chul Yish Mekoyimim Sheein Aymer Mizeh Mekoyimim Beis Avel. There's some places don't say Zeh Mekayman in the house of an Avel. Why? Nishasar v'talmud Taira. The whole reason we're saying Zeh Mekayman is to learn Taira. So in a Beis Avel in which you don't learn Taira, they don't say Zeh Mekayman. Ve'ein Zeh Nach. Says Mishmur, that's incorrect. Shekol Shu Seder Ayayim Im Misham Talmud Taira La'avel. Because it's the Seder of the day, it's not called Talmud Taira. Kamash Nifzik B'sim Tavkof Nun Dalid. Sif Dalid. And I believe that those are the halachas with regard to Tisha B'Av, that there are those that say we could, yes, say Zeh Mekayman, because since it's part of the Seder Ayayim, but I have to double check that detail. Continues Mishnah Berurah, Sivkat and Beis, Shah Medrash Ki Gemara, Ubacharu Braisa Zu, they pick this Braisa, then they should Chilas Tayrus Kohanim, it's the beginning of Tayrus Kohanim, Shu Raish the whole Parshas Karbanais, which is the beginning of all the Karbanais, Kavu Eitzel Karbanais, they put it next to their Karbanais. Chain Baracharu Mishnah Zizah Mekayman, Kavu Acher Tamid. Similarly, they chose Zizah Mekayman, they placed it after the Tamid. Misham Shinamru, Chamaka Makdir, Umugash, Lishmi, V'chibachol, Maka Makdir, and Magishin. Is that true? Elo Eilu Tamid Cham Shaiskin Bilchaz Avoida. These are the Tevin Chaim. They are Isaac, that they deal with all aspects of the Avoda all day. Again, learning the incredible importance of saying the Karbanais, that it's viewed as if we brought the Karbanais. Furthermore, another interesting detail about Izeh Mekayim, there's no machlokes in the Perek. It's a clear Mishnah from Moshe all the way back from Har Sinai. And again, similar to yesterday, the Mishnah Berurah reminds us that reading these words alone are not enough of Izeh Mekayim and the Braisa of Yishmael. You have to understand them. You have to learn it to understand it. It's not called learning. Specifically, tefillah, even without knowing what you're saying, Hashem knows your kavana. It's not called learning if you don't understand that which you are saying. With Frada, Maratzas, Aruch, Shayav, Inu, Aperosh, you have to at least understand the explanation. You should say the same nigin as Mishnayis. Just looking quickly here, note number 4 points out that afa loymid gemara, even one that generally learns gemara, and derek chla yishva mikro mishnah, and that's where Rabbeinu Tam holds that learning Talmud Bavli yoytzi your chiyav of mikro mishnah. Still, the Kaf HaChaim points out, Mikol Makom Yizoyer Loimer is the Braisa of Mishnah. You should be careful to see this Braisa of Mishnah. Why? Shkini Tachin Shein Ba'isa Sugya Mikra Mishnah. It could be that if you learn a piece of Gemara, even if you learn a daf, not necessarily you're learning a Mishnah every daf or Psukim every daf. And that's the reason why they were Mesakein to say the Braisa of Rabbi Yishmael and Izeh Mekayman each and every day. We continue with Simin Nun Aleph that the Mechaber coins Dinei Tefillah Min Baruch Shamad Yishtabach. And now we're segueing, we learn Hilchos Tefillin, we learn Hilchos Birchas HaShachar, and now we segue into Psukei Dezimra, from the halachas of Tefillah, from Baruch Shamar until Yishabach. Says the Mechaber in Sefal of Aymer Baruch Shamar, Koidem Psukei Dezimra, Yishabach L'Achreihem. These are the bookends of Psukei Dezimra, or Baruch Shamar, and Yishabach. Says the Mishnah Berurah, Sefkot Anal of Baruch Shamar, Shevach Zeh Tiknua Chiknes Ha'gdolei De Piska. Now we get the origins, the famous origins of Baruch Shamar, says the Mishnah Berurah, quoting the latter Achrayim, that this tefillah of Baruch Shamar, the Anshik Nisla Gdolah, were misakin, al yidei pitka denavim in a shamayim, a piece of paper, a petak, fell from heaven. Umatu kasav boy, they found Baruch Shamar written on it. An absolutely fascinating phenomena, and perhaps even more fascinating that the story is brought down already all the way through the Achrayim into the Mishnah Berurah. V'yesh boy pei zayin oisye tevois. Baruch Shamar's 87 words. V'simana roishay kesem baz. Ratzalaymer, what does that mean? Roish at tefila, the beginning of davening, who brachas al pizay and devais. Roish kesem pos, the beginning of davening is 87 words. Alkin inli groiv lelos val pizam and devus. So you have to be very careful. Don't miss a word. Don't add a word. V'nochin laymer mu'umad v'afilu b'yechidi. You should stand and you're saying Baruch Shamar even when you're by yourself. V'echash deitzitzas shalvan of you hold of two front tzitzas b'shas amiras Baruch Shamar. Ulach egemar Baruch Shamar yinashkin, then you kiss them. Pepe amoy b'segol b'atish b'chayis b'chirik b'atish b'chayis b'chirik. And we learn Sif Beis, the Machaber teaches us, Imsiyim Baruch Shamar, Kodim Shazin HaChazin. If you finish Baruch Shamar before the Chazin does, Oyne Acharav, Amen, then you should say Amen to the Chazin's Bracha. When the Chazin finishes Baruch Shamar. Says Mishnah Berurah, Sif Kodim Beis, Imsiyim, Avalim Lo Yisiyim, Lo Yana Amen. Upash, the Davka Mishan Shizcha Baruch, Ata Hashem Vechulu. It's Pasha that once you begin the Bracha, the Mitchila Shavucha Ba'alma, because the beginning of Baruch Shamar, that's a Shevach. So what does it mean you shouldn't interrupt your Baruch Shamar to say Amin to the Chazin's Baruch Shamar? Only if you're up to the end of Baruch Shamar and you said Baruch to Hashem. B'chol zedav kalinin Amin shal Baruch Shamar shal yishtavach. Aval shari Aminim, all other Amins, Masik Magin Avram, Sifkot, the Gintan, the Mutlano, Yisavim Lubem, Zav Bircha, Bircha's Baruch Shamar yishtavach. While you're in the middle of Baruch Shamar yishtavach, you're allowed to answer Amin. You just can't answer Amin to the actual Bracha that you're saying. Kivin shal uzkar Baruch Zubi Gemara. Ah, however, because you should not answer the Bzem Mekalkel Gamri as a bracha. Because then that could mess up the bracha. Says the Mishnah Berurah, Sifkot and Gimel Achazin, Avalim Sin, Im Achazin, Vasachas, if you finish together with the Chazin, Lo Yan Amin, you don't answer Amin. Why? It looks like you're answering Amin to your own bracha. It's Kaimelon Davi, Maguna, that is disgusting to answer Amin to your own bracha. Degrading vo adin b'chol brachas adin kein the same way all brachas davar be yishtabach oya alucha acher alel oya acher shama yisalad im siim b'shavim mashas you finish directly at the same time with the shechsiber oya madam acher still oya amen why the harbe pais kim sevir le debzayin afilu acher brachas atzmai because these are unique brachas yishtabach yalucha shama yisrael that we can really answer amen to your own brach after nam lani higin we don't do that. If you finish at the same time as the Chazin, if you finish any bracha, then the only time you can answer Amen is if you're saying the same bracha as the Sheikh Sieber. But if you finish first, then the Shatz finishes, you should yes say Acharav Amen, Sifkan, and Dalid. But Lo Yahave, we turn over the page over here, says the Mishnah Berurah, Lo Yahave Hefsik, Bein HaBrach LeDavar, it's not a Hefsik. Why? Kipsuket Zimra is praising Hashem. Vamein Shevachu and Amein is praising Hashem. Okay, in Zimra v'lavei Hefsik. Therefore, it's a form of praise. Therefore, it's not called a Hefsik. So to say Amein during Kipsuket Zimra is allowed because it's not called a Hefsik. V'imsach Dvarim Betilim Bein Baruch Shamar Lahidu. If someone spoke, Efshin Zar Lach Zavarim Misham Hefsik. It's possible you have to make a new bracha Baruch Shamar. Avilu Mila Achas Avi Hefsik. We see the incredible importance of not being Mavsik during Baruch, during Pesukei Zimra, because the Mishnah Berurah is teaching us that if you are Mavzik, you might have to actually repeat Baruch Sha'amar. When you're Elisha, if he's there, if you're Bishtika, Toiv Lizar, Lechatchil, Shlolisha, Zar, Bimein Taim, you shouldn't even have a lot of silence, because that itself could be a Hefsik. We'll pick it up from Sif Gimel as we continue learning the halachas of Baruch.